So before we jump to Simulink and see the implementation of the block diagram of the motor model, let us go through the mathematical modeling. So we are going to develop a transfer function model that relates the motor speed with the applied input voltage. So here is the diagram that illustrates how the input voltage is electromechanically related to the speed of the motor. Here are the motor variables as well as the values of the variables we are going to use for our example. So for the mathematical modeling, we are going to consider two equations. So the motor model has two equations. The first equation is the electrical equation, and we are going to develop that using the Kirchhoff's voltage law. So according to that law, the summation of the EMF minus the summation of the voltage drop in the electrical loop is equal to zero. So we have our EMF is the applied voltage, and for the voltage drops, we have the voltage drop across the resistance, that is the armature resistance, and then the voltage drop across the armature inductance, and then we have the back EMF, and it is equal to zero. So this one will reduce to this equation, and it is in time domain. For transfer function, convert it into S domain, and we do that using the Laplace transform. So here is the S domain form of the equation, and the back EMF is directly proportional to the speed of the motor, and the constant of proportionality is the back EMF constant, which is Ke. Therefore, we have our electrical equation reduced to 1, which is this equation. So the second equation is the mechanical equation, and we are going to use the Newton's second law of rotational motion to come up with that. So it said that the summation of the torque applied is just equal to J, which is the moment of inertia, times the omega dt. So we have the summation of torque is just the applied torque minus the damping torque, which is given by B omega, and B is the damping coefficient, is equal to J d omega dt. So we convert also that to S domain using Laplace transform, and we have this equation. And the applied torque is directly proportional to the armature current. And the constant of proportionality is Kt, which is the torque constant. So we have Kti is equal to Js omega plus B omega. And we have our armature current reduced to this equation. So substituting equation 2 into 1, we have our Ba is equal to the right-hand side. And we have our Ba and the motor speed related by this. Therefore, our transfer function will just be equal to omega over Ba is equal to the right-hand side. And expanding, we have this to be our final transfer function model. So we already have the values from the previous slide, and substituting the values, we have this equation, and we can reduce it further to this form. So this is the transfer function model of the motor we are going to consider. So now let us move to Simulink and see the implementation. So here we are in Simulink. So in order to simulate this, we need to tie the input voltage, which is the armature voltage. We also need to visualize the speed, and here is our model. So we need three things: the input, the model, as well as the output. So for the input, if you double click on the screen, it will allow you to select the component you want to use in Simulink. So I want a step. So here is my step, and I need a transfer function. So I will type transfer. Here it is. So I will click on it, and then I need the scope for visualization, and here is it. So I can expand the block and then change its name to motor model and make it even bigger by coming to format and then changing the size, for example, to say to 24. So I have my motor model. So by default, the transfer function model is 1 over S plus 1. So you can change that, and you can adjust any component in Simulink by double clicking on it. So all you need to do is to input the correct numerator coefficient and the denominator coefficient. So for my numerator coefficient, I have 10. And for my denominator coefficient, I have 1. Then I have 100.1. And then I have 11. So by doing that, we just click on apply. And then OK. So you can see it has changed to your transfer function model. So all I need to do now is to connect the signals, so you can drag from one block to another. And also from here, I drag it to my scope for visualization. You can change the name of the signal. So I can change this one as my input. I can increase the size, for example, to 14. And here I have my output. And I can change also to 14. I can change this one, my voltage. And this one, my visualizer. So you can also use the dashboard scope for inline visualization. So I can just put dashboard scope and I have it here. So you just double click on it to select the signals you want to visualize. So I want to visualize my inputs. And also I want to visualize my outputs. And then you just apply and then OK. So for the input voltage, you can give it any value and see how it responds. So initially it is at 1. The value, final value, is 1 volt. So let us see how it responds to 1 volt. So after clicking on run, you can see after applying a voltage of 1 volt, started like slowly and then settles at around 0.6 rad per second. So for example, if I change the input, for example, to say 5. And then click on run again. You can see it has increased to almost 2 point something rad per second. This is just open loop control in which I manually applied the voltage without considering the current state of the output and then observe how the motor respond. So I cannot use this to achieve certain control objective. In order to automatically generate appropriate voltage that will drive my motor to certain speed, I need to use closed loop control. And I can achieve that using different control algorithms. In this video, we are going to use PID control. So I can just double click and then type PID. So this is the PID controller. I then remove this signal, remove this one, and then I have my PID here. So this one is no longer the input. This one will be my desired output or reference. So I will change the name to desired motor speed. I need a summer to compare between the desired motor speed and the actual motor speed. So I have some so I need to connect the signal, connect it here, then change the configuration. Initially it is adding two signals, so I want to compare. So I need plus minus to take the difference, and I need to connect this block here, also this one here, and then I take from here, I take it here. So now I have my closed loop. So this one is the desired motor speed. And this signal is the actual motor speed. Actual motor speed. So let me double click just to make sure that I'm visualizing the required signals. So you can see I have the desired motor speed and the actual motor speed, which are the signals I want to visualize. So now it is the PID that is automatically generating the armature voltage. So I have the input voltage here. And let me use another dashboard scope for visualizing the input voltage. So I just have to double click on it and then to select the signal I want to visualize, which is the input voltage. So one thing with PID is if you double click on it. So here are the proportional, integral and derivative gains. So we have to tune this manually or use methods like this Glanekos method to have a good first guess. However, Simulink has the option of tuning the parameters for you. So you can automatically tune the parameters, the PID parameters using this tune app. So if I click on tune, so it will open this PID tuner app for you. As you can see, I have the two response based on the slider positions here, and I have the block response based on the default parameters in the PID block. So as I am moving it, the slider, you can see the response is getting better. So I can make it more robust. So if you achieve the desired response you want, you just have to click on update block and the parameters here will be loaded onto your PID block. So I think this response, the one on the straight line, is a bit good for me. I will just click on update block. After clicking on update block, you just close and you will see the parameters that gives you that behavior are loaded in the PID block. So I just have to click on OK and then click on run. So this is the input voltage that was automatically generated by the PID. And from this scope, you can see this is the desired motor speed and the red line is the actual motor speed. You can see, although it is a bit slow, it eventually settles at the desired motor speed. So we can make this better from the tuner app. If you want to learn more about Simulink and its features, watch the video on the top. And if you want to learn more about building block diagrams for mass spring dumper system, watch the video on the bottom. Please like and subscribe to the channel. Thank you and see you in our upcoming videos.